हेलो गाइस, क्लास सिक्स हियर वी आर प्रेजेंट टू जसवंत आर एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द चैप्टर नंबर फाइव विच इज सेपरेशन ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस. आई एम योर साइंस टीचर राशिद खान फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल गोलाबाजार. हियर आर द सम रिमेनिंग चैप्टर विल हैव टू कंप्लीटेड आर द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर विल हैव टू कंप्लीटेड दैट इज सेपरेशन ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस. In which the separation of a substance, I have already explained about the method of a separation. Here are the some method of a separation are given as a hand picking, tracing, winnowing, sieving or sifting, that is magnetic separation. These are all about that the separation of a substance from solid to solid. That means mixture of solid to solid. When these mixtures are present solid in solid, it will have to just separate by using winnowing method, tracing method, or by hand picking, or by sieving and magnetic separation. So as I have earlier told you about that the hand picking is the method of a separation in which when the impurities or the stones got a number of impurities got, it cannot be separated by any other things. It can be separated by a hand or manually. So the impurities are the stones removed from the rice or grains, you can say. When the impurity removes from the grains, which is in a larger extent, so this one is only can be done by the hand picking or the manual. As the most of the governments daily by daily in their food material or the grains, they have to separate or they have to remove these such type of impurities or stones or other material present in it or the different sizes and shapes. So it will have to remove and the pure substance is remain same. So this is about hand picking. Next one is a tracing. Tracing is the medium in which the farmer get separated the husk or chaffs from the grains, or you can say is stuck from the grains. It is the process in which when the farmers are after being maturation of a crops, when the farmers supposed to the crops are completely mature, it will has to be separated out in that form by the process of threshing. And threshing can be done by the means of manual, by hand, or by bullocks, or by your tractors. And nowadays it is a very advanced time, and in this time we can say here the number of combined harvester are there, and this will form in a very easiest manner. What are these? In the combined harvester there is no need to separate the chops, and there is no need to just carry on the such type of these husk material into a large extent. It is within a one time it can separate the husk and can separate as well as the grains from the others. So the combined harvester is the modern age, or this is about that the very modern nowadays to separate the grains from the stalk. And the next one is tractor. Tractor is another form nowadays. It can also separate the husk or the chops from the grains, and the heavier material is remain over there at the both places, and there is a husk are separate from the grains. They are distinct from one and other. The next thing is by the bullocks. As you know that there is a husk, there is a crops which is spread throughout the field, and the farmers is allowed to bullocks to crush them all by their feet. It's running more and more time, it's repeated time and time, and the grains are separated from the chaffs as well. And the rest, the one is by the hand, by the manual in which the farmer separated the grains by beating the bundle of a husk in a smaller quantities, and beating it up to a hard object like a rock or like a stone or might be on a wooden plank, iron plank, whatever it is, it has to be separated. Now there is the threshing. Winnowing is another method by which the grains or heavier grains may be separated from the chaff one by using a wind. Next is sieving or sifting. You can know sieving and sifting is another method by which the different sizes of the impurities can be separated out. Next is magnetic separation. Magnetic separation is the separation in which the metallic object be separated by using the magnets, and this can be very useful for separating the iron material. And in a large extent or in a large quantities, when there is a scrap found or might be the wastes are there in which the metallic or you can say the iron object are there, it will be removed or separated out by the means of what? The magnetic crane, or you can say electromagnets. These are the large amount of a magnet which is run by the electric tools, and in this way the magnets can easily separate the iron object from the crab. And here is the next one, the next method of a separation of solid from liquid. Separation of solid from liquid. So we can see this is also the mixture of solid and mixture of liquid. This will have to be separated from one another by the different method. Here is method given as first one, sedimentation. Next one is decantation. Next is loading, and last one is filtration. This is all about that the method of a separation of a liquid and solid or solid and liquid mixture. So in that segment we can know that we know that the sedimentation is what? Sedimentation. That means if there is a material which is solid liquid mixture. If there is a amount of mixture present in such a way that here is some of the material, it is a liquid material which is dissolving solid material which is dissolving liquid, this would not be dissolved. Why? Because their density are different from one another. So when these heavier material is allowed to settle down in a mixture, when the heavier material is allowed to get settled down, these materials which got settled down are called as, what they call as? They are called as the sediments. They are called as the sediments. And the process by which is allowed to settle down in the bottom of the vessels, this process is called as the sedimentation. Sedimentation. And the next one, here we can see, they are upper clear liquid, the upper clear portion of a liquid. The upper clear liquid. These upper clear liquids are separated out. This one is called as suprantend. this one is called as a supreme tank. And where these upper clear liquid is removed or poured into another vessel without disturbing the sediment, then this one is called as this one is called as the decantation. This is called the decantation. This one is called decantation. So we can say decantation is the process through which the upper clear liquid is poured in another vessel without disturbing the sediment. This one is called decantation. Or sedimentation is what? Sedimentation is the method of separating two component in a such a way that the heavier substance gets settled down. This one. And decantation is what actually? The process of obtaining liquid from the insoluble solid is called as the decantation. This one is insoluble solid, which is without disturbing the sediment when it is found. Then this one is called as the decantation. And this one is called supernal tank. Already I am telling you supernal tank. So when the insoluble solid is found by the process, that is a decantation. Why? Decantation is what? When the process or the method by which obtaining of the insoluble solid but without disturbing the sediment, this one is called as a decantation. Next is, if you suppose there is a sand which is dissolved with water, this is insoluble. So the rest of the insoluble particles which have to be settled down, the allowance of get settled down of such insoluble substance or insoluble impurities which is settled down at the bottom of the vessel, this one is called as the sedimentation. And when these, the upper clear liquid which is a liquid present, this will has to be removed, and the insoluble impurities which is we can obtain, the process, the obtaining of these insoluble impurities or a substance is called decantation. Suppose if there is a sand mixed with water, the water will, the upper clear portion and the rest of the impurities which is got settled down at the bottom. So that one is about what? The impurities we got can got by the decantation and the settling down. The process through which these can settle down, this one is called as the sedimentation. So this is all about the sedimentation and decantation. We now can move to the next one, that is loading. This is the method of separating the suspended particles. Method of separating the suspended particles. And you can say the suspended impurities are suspended impurities. You can say the suspended particles. This is the process of obtaining the suspended part substance. Suspended particles of gas. Suspended particles from the gas or liquid. Particles from either gas or liquid. Then by making them heavier, by making them heavier. How it can be making them heavier? Loading is the process through which the suspended particles to obtaining the suspended particle from the gas or the liquid by the making them the heavier. How they can be making heavier? This can be making heavier by applying or by supplying or using the material. So loading is the process in which alum particle is deposited on the suspended clay, particles of muddy water to make them heavy and get settled down. As example, when we have taken the muddy water in which the muddy water gets settled down, but it cannot be deposited when there is a clay particles. The clay particles get dissolved or get settled by using the alum. Alum that can help to just deposited all the suspended impurities in it. So the process in which the suspended impurities get dissolved or get suspended by using and other materials, this one is called loading. So you can say for instant separation or for instant settling down of the suspended particles, if we are going to use another material, this one is called as a loading. So loading is another method. Next one is a filtration. What is the filtration? You can show the filtration by different means. Filtration is in our daily life. You can see filtration day by day. At in the morning time, when there is a tea time, so the tea is firstly filtered throughout the strainer. Strainer is the filter, the medium of the filtration. So the tea leaves get separated from the tea by using a very simple strainer. So you can say the filtration is the medium. Filtration or the process through which the insoluble impurities or insoluble solid particles get separated from the liquid by using a filtering medium or the filter. This one is called as a filtration. And you can see the liquid passes through into cup and container. The process of separating insoluble substance from a liquid is called filtration. So it is very easy. It is what? Separation. You can see the process of separation. The process of separating solid substance. Solid substance from liquid by using a filtering device. By using the filtering device is called
filtration.
This is for filtration. As we know, the tea leaves separated by tea using filter. This filter is what we call strainer. Through the strainer we can separate the tea leaves from the tea. So this is all about that, the filtration, and rest of the other parts we will discuss later. Thank you for watching. Keep watching and comment if there is any doubt or queries. So write comment in the comment box. Thank you. We'll meet again.